Good morning, cellar dwellers, and welcome to another segment of BassHacks by me, Henry James. It's a happy Saturday morning, a couple days after Thanksgiving. Hope everybody's burning off that turkey. Just coming at you, figured I'd have the day off today. I'm going to see the Trans-Siberian Orchestra later, and just wanted to make a quick video of something cool. And probably my number one influence, favorite band in the world. And just like King's X, these guys mean a lot to me because without their music, I probably never would have picked up the bass guitar. So I hope everybody's well. Hope everybody enjoyed the last two videos. The King's X one, I need some work on that. The tuning's funky and it's just great music, but I definitely want to do something. I want to play that music next year. So, Winter Wonderland was awesome. I'm working on Elvis songs. We got a couple big gigs coming up that I am playing at. I know might have been some issues, but I am playing the next two Elvis gigs, which is the Black Box Theater on December 2nd. Christmas show, and Point Breeze on December 16th, Christmas show. I will be playing at both of those shows. A couple of health scares going on. I'm not going to get into it too much. Just want to play some tunes and some music. This band here, they get a bad rap and they get flack for everything. For everything they've been doing for 50 years. But as of all successful bands, they've been together for 50 years. They're closing it out on their farewell tour. I think this is their third or fourth farewell tour, but I think this is it. We won't be seeing them anymore, at least in original form or somewhat original form. The band I'm doing today is Kiss. As you know, I just did a great little gig with Guy Torrio, Tony Ryan and Bob Pendleton, all Bose employees. We did the Bose Jam, Bud Jam 2023. We picked some Kiss songs to play. This one didn't make the cut. And I just kind of learned it a little bit because it is the song. This is the song that made me pick up the bass guitar. And the bass guitar I have today is, I just got done upgrading this bad boy. This is my 2013 Epiphone Classic Pro T-Bird. Set neck through. What do they call this? Polar white. And it's just an absolutely magnificent bass. I have the US version of this, but I always prefer this one. It's got that whole thing. Well, I upgraded it with some Hip Shot Ultralight Cloverleaf tuners, period correct. And I got a Hip Shot full contact bridge in place of that 3-point bridge that was on here, which I couldn't deal with. I'm not sure what these pickups are. I took them out yesterday to look at them. This one rings out at 9K, this one rings out at 8K. They're not very powerful. They sound okay. They were wobbly and all kinds of stuff. I had to shim them up with some foam and new springs under the strings and whatnot. Now this bass is a monster. What I am looking for, if anybody's got any suggestions in the comments below, are good T-Bird pickup upgrades. That would probably be the only thing I do to this. Maybe. I don't know. It kind of sounds great the way it is, but I love this bass. Let's see. I am running through my Doug panic pedal set to my settings into my TC Electronics BH250 into my Eden EX112. Bass is tuned down a half step because, as you know, Kiss tunes down. I call it Black Sabbath tuning. It was the first time I ever encountered tuning down a half step was with playing Black Sabbath music in the late 70s and early 80s. So I call it Sabbath tuning. Even though Kiss was doing it right from the beginning also. So I tuned down a half step so everything's sharp and flat. And it's got some great sound. This bass got some... It's track I'm going to play to today is probably one of my favorite Kiss songs. And like I said, it was what got me into, it's what got me playing bass. And why I love the Thunderbirds so much. Now, you don't see me playing them out too often. Heavy, neck heavy, but I love these instruments and I'll always own a few of them. So, Mississippi's. So why don't we get right into it and make this video a quick one, so I can get out of here, get some lunch with my girl. Me and my love, we're going to see the TSO, and should be a great time, listening to some wonderful Christmas tunes done by rock and roll musicians and orchestra pit musicians, all sharing the same stage. So it should be a blast. So let's get into it right now and play this track. Now, it's just the timing's a little funky because I have a hard time hearing. I don't have setups like everybody else. Basically, I just got a camera, an amp, a computer. That's it. I don't have great editing software and I don't have all the fancy stuff that everybody else has. That's why it's called BassHacks. I don't claim to be an expert. I don't claim to be Johnny Bass expert. I don't claim to be any of that. I just play what I hear. I play what I feel. I play what I see. And that's it. I'm just me. That's why it's called BassHacks. So let's do it. Which mouse is it? Thank you. was a shitload of fun.
Photography has been a lifelong passion.
That was a shitload of fun. I lost the time in a little bit because I got wrapped up into the tune. The riff is, everybody shits all over Gene Simmons, but man. Can't think that is an awesome bass riff. That's what got hooked me into playing bass. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. Hope you enjoyed this Thunderbird, because man, what a beautiful instrument. They say that the cheap stuff can't be as good as the good stuff. Well, this is living proof. I'll do a review putting this T-Bird. Mind you, it's got a bunch of upgrades, but so doesn't my American one to make it play right. I'm going to put this one up against my American one, and we'll see who wins the shootout. I kind of already know who will, but like I said, look at that. This bass is absolutely magnificent, and it looks so good with the cloverleaf hipshot ultralight cloverleaf. The only thing I didn't like about them was they got the matte aluminum finish on the peg post instead of being chrome all the way around. That's the only thing I didn't like them, but it stays in tune, it plays beautiful, and this bass is road worthy. Listen, y'all, Christmas is coming. I can't stress this enough to all of you. Be good to your fellow man, be kind to your spouses, take extra special care in your family this year, and I hope Christmas brings greatness for everybody. And I hope that song right there made everybody smile a little bit today. I love y'all. Peace out. Please click like, share, subscribe. And leave in the comments below whether you think that was helpful, great, not helpful, whatever. I don't care. I just know I have fun. Like I said, I play things that I hear. I play things my way. I don't claim to be an expert. I don't claim to be Gene Simmons, but he is a huge influence. And I don't claim to be an expert in anything other than what goes on in my head. Listen, thank you all again. Y'all take care of yourselves. Peace out. Love y'all. We'll see you soon. As for health issues, we all have them. We all have our crosses to bear. Everybody keep fighting. Everybody keep living. Don't ever give up. And let music be your savior. Thank you all. God bless everybody. God bless you. God bless the world we live in. He sure could use it right now. And this is Henry James for Bass Hacks by Henry James. Out. Y'all take care of yourself. Have a good one.